And then just loosely pour the water out. You don't have to pour all of it out. And you need to do this at least 5 or 6 times. So now this is really almost done. So now this time around, I just put enough water so it covers it by about 1 inch or so. And then leave it to soak for about 30 minutes. I'm heating about 2 tablespoons of oil in this pot for the rice.
What is the oil?
Usually it would be peanut oil or corn oil, and they do use refined sesame oil as well. It's very traditional and very old. They've used that for 3,000 years in India. So there's the oil, and into this are going to go some spices, and the reason for putting them in hot oil is to change their intensity, the intensity of their flavor. So about a 2-inch stick of cinnamon, and 3 wonderful green cardamom pods, which will go in.
See, those are interesting, aren't they?
Yes, that's...
And that...
See how it opens up?
When you say it changes, does it intensify?
It does, it does. And now, the next thing is the shallots. About 1 shallot that has been cut into very fine slivers.
One great big shallot.
One great big shallot, exactly. They come in all sizes, don't they? And they seem to be getting bigger by the minute.
Yes, they do.
So this time, unlike European food, I'm going to not just sauté it, I'm going to let it brown. Because when they're browned, they give a very different flavor to the rice and also give it a little color. Now this is more like it. And the next thing that goes in is the rice. Remember, I washed the rice, then I drained it, then I left it in a strainer so that all the water comes out. Now, the next thing is to turn the heat down slightly, and very gently I'm going to sauté it. But also going to add the dill. There's about a whole cup of chopped dill.
That really is in fairly
it's a lot
firmly
of dill.
Packed.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. And about a teaspoon of salt. And this needs to be sautéed. I was saying earlier that there are 3 ways that you can keep rice grains separate. So one of them was, of course, the washing. The other was soaking, because each grain absorbs its water and then tends to stay away from the other grain. And the third is sautéing. When you surround each grain with a little oil or fat of some kind, again, it keeps it separate from its neighbor. And you do it very gently, because at this stage, the basmati rice has soaked and it's become very delicate. So you don't want to break the grains, and they break very easily. Now, this is, you don't need to sauté it any more than that. The next thing that goes in is stock. This is 2 2/3 cup of chicken stock. And I measure the stock by volume. So if you've measured your rice in a cup, it's a good idea to take the same cup and measure the stock. And for every cup of rice, unsoaked rice, it's 1 1/3 only of liquid. So as soon as it comes to the boil like this, because we are cooking it with so little liquid, and I want a very tight-fitting lid, which this is not, I'm going to first put a piece of foil on top, then mash the lid down and make sure that it is well closed, because it's really going to steam. And we can now take this to the oven, to a 325 degree oven. And
what we have.
Okay. And in it goes.
How long?
Set it for 30 minutes to be on the safe side, 25 to 30.
I'll put it at 25, there.
All right. Now it's time to finish off the shrimp dish, because the rice is almost ready. And here's the concentrate, which I'm going to heat up.
Lovely sauce that we made.
The concentrated sauce. Now this has the salt. It's salty, it's hot, and it's sour. And I need to add another element to it, which is the sweet. And the sweet comes from coconut milk. And what you can buy coconuts fairly easily now, but they're not always good quality. And the way to tell if it's good, first you look at it, mm-hmm. and you pick one that seems heavy. You take several, sort of juggle sense. Them, and take the heaviest. Mm-hmm. And always, if you need one, buy two, because one may be bad. And then you shake it, make sure that it has a lot of water, mm-hmm. that there's no mold. These are the eyes, mm-hmm. that there's no mold. Mm-hmm. And then you crack it open with a hammer outside. I do it outside on a mm-hmm. stone. Let the water that's in there run out. And then you pry out the coconut meat, which should be white like this, mm-hmm. and peel it. And then all that you do is cut it into fairly small pieces, throw it into a food processor, add a little hot water, mm-hmm. and blend it all, and then strain it through a cheesecloth. Uh-huh. And that's coconut milk. It's not what comes out mm-hmm. of here. That's coconut water. That's coconut milk. But we don't have to do any of that. Mm-hmm. Because very good quality coconuts and younger coconuts than this are made into coconut milk and canned. That's why I prefer the can of coconut milk. This is a good quality Thai coconut. That. And also, it's not yellow. It's very white. And mm-hmm. the other thing I want to show you is that there's cream that rises to the top mm-hmm. of the coconut can. So even before you take it out, before you taste it, I'm going to stir it. So you see how uneven it is? Mm-hmm. So I'm going to stir it like this. This is roughly a 14-ounce can. Mm-hmm.
This is boiling.
Yeah,
is that
I know.
Okay?
Yeah, this should go in right now.
Leave a little
Do you want
bit
to
so
taste?
I can taste
yeah.
it.
It should be nice, sweet, and creamy.
And that is nice, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's a very good quality coconut milk. And then, almost as a garnish, not really for the flavor, but for a little bit of flavor is going to come out of these chilies from their skin. Mm-hmm. But I want the taste of the skin, and a little bit as a garnish as well. You take three mm-hmm. or four, it really doesn't matter. Leave their stems on and throw them in.
Just leave
like
them
that.
Whole. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now this needs to come to a boil. Canned coconut milk should not be cooked for a long time, because the oil, there's so much oil in the coconut mm-hmm. milk that the oil begins to separate, and you yeah. want it not to mm-hmm. separate. This is 2 pounds of shrimp, mm-hmm. and they've been peeled and deveined, but I'll just for those who don't know, I'm sure everyone knows how to peel shrimp now. You just pull off the skin. They're very elaborate peelers that you can buy now. And I just do it the old-fashioned. Well, I find
them
mangled. I think they mangle the prawn, the ones I've seen. And then you just devein it. And I like to wash them and pat them dry. Mm-hmm. So now let's see what's happening here. So the sauce is ready, and in go the 2 pounds of
beautiful. And I think you always have to smell the shrimp to make sure that
absolutely.
They're absolutely perfect.
None of that iodine-y taste, which I really don't like. And they don't take very long, so they just poach till they are opaque, and then they're ready.
Well, they're already turning. Oh, yes.
And the chilies, as you can see, just act as a kind of pretty
mm-hmm,
garnish.
Because
we've got it hot enough, really.
I didn't realize that Indian cooking had so much chili in it.
Well, it can. This is southern. See, northern food doesn't.
Mm-hmm.
Southern food can be very, very hot. And in fact, they would have it even hotter than this. Mm-hmm.
You don't eat with chopsticks at all.
No, it's considered so unsensuous in India. They make fun of people who eat with utensils.
This is the whole, you're supposed to eat it with your fingers.
With your fingers, because mm-hmm. that's the whole sensuous thing of enjoying mm-hmm. the food, taking it up with your fingers and mm-hmm. licking your fingers. It's all considered very exciting.
Then you pass great big napkins along? Or,
no, you wash. You have to wash.
Okay, do you have a little bowl right in front of you?
You can. Mm-hmm. You can, or usually just go to the faucet and wash your hands.
Yes.
So now this is really really done.
Boring.
I think this is done, and we can turn it off. Well, the shrimp is done. Let's see if the rice is done. It should be.
Well, this is crucial of knowing.
Let's look. There's a lot of steam, so you open it carefully. It looks perfect. See, look at the grains.
Mm-hmm.
And see, they're all separate, fluffy. Take a taste, please.
They are separate and fluffy. I certainly don't. That's delicious.
Good.
I love the dill in it.
And the cinnamon you can just discard.
It's very, very subtle.
So you just fluff it up very lightly, and again you can still ruin rice by serving it badly. Fluff it up like this. Now we're going to serve some.
This one you could break it up if you.
You break the grains and they don't look pretty. Mm-hmm. So you just take some. Depends on how much you want to
serve.
Sort
of fluffing it. Yeah.
Yes. Put some rice here. And then we'll take some of the prawns with their sauce and put it on the other side. Mm. Well, how much should we give? 5? Maybe that. Mm. I'm going to garnish with 2 of the cooked chilies. Don't eat them, they're deadly. And a sprig of dill.
Oh, that's a beautiful main course. It's lovely to have had you with us. I've only met you once. That was years ago. But we were in India during World War II. And I wish that you had been there so I could have you could have told me a great deal about it. But it's just been a great pleasure
to have you. Thank you. I've enjoyed being here so much. It's really a pleasure.
Well, you've given us a window onto a cuisine that very few people here know. And I thank you, madam.
Thank you. I keep learning. I feel I never know enough myself, and every time I go back to India, there's so much more to find out. It's